Hey guys, and welcome to Behind the Bunker, episode 86 here at beautiful Behind the Bunker studio. This is our final show in the studio until we are in our Florida compound next week, guys. For a minute there, I thought I was, yeah. Guys, my name is Todd Answers. Thank you for joining us this evening. Tonight on the show, we are talking about the subject, if you could put a number on it, how many times have you actually gone out and played paintball? Most of you are new to the sport, may have a quick answer. Some of you that have been playing for a long time, like most of us on the panel, it's going to be a harder question. We are going to be giving away another Murdertron t-shirt tonight. We are going to talk to you about behind the bunker headbands. We have loads of questions that have been emailed and sent in to us, so we're going to try and get to as many as we can tonight. Cat Shack, of course, has a great segment that he sent in. The team that we're featuring tonight on our show is Jersey Instinct, so stay tuned for that.
Jersey Shorts?
I don't know.
They got canceled.
It's hard to tell what their hair is like because they all wear hats when they play. And very we spooky. Will see where Behind the Bunker is over the next few weeks on the road.
Again.
Is it my turn now?
It is your turn.
Thank you, Josh.
Hi, I'm Josh Zurikis. I'll bring you lots of events for paintball around the world this evening. Track 21 sent us a great video from Paintball Explosion, and if we have time, you can see me in my very own custom corner and vault video.
Now, Josh, that jump in was so perfectly done, I think it deserves the video of the night. Can we show that?
No, we can't. Oh,
that was
fantastic.
Sharp. No.
All right, guys, we have lots of videos tonight. We have videos from Colonel Mustard, Snarky, The Professor, Beaker, 300 feet per second, a magnificent, great vault segment, if I do say so myself. It's a prequel to World Cup 2012, and lots of photos from Custom Corner that you guys have submitted to me to talk about to you.
I'm Gavin Sharma from TerraTech Industries, and there is something that is grinding our gears here at Behind the Bunker, and we'll get to that later on. What's up with that? And we're going to be looking at a short documentary, March for Fitness, which asks the question, paintball, is it something you play that can actually get you fit? We'll take a look at that later on today.
There was someone famous in that video. Two people that were famous in that
infamous,
video.
Infamous, I believe.
Mm-hmm. Now, speaking of that video, on our couch in Studio B, we have Chris Christofferson, our intern, and a new guest on our show, Andy Horhane. Welcome, Andy. How are you?
Thank you, guys.
Andy, for those of you that we were just talking about, was the gentleman who put together that video, and we'll talk about that a little bit more as the night goes on. Very good. You have to get out of here by 9, so we'll try and get you out of here by 9. He has a Lamaze class to get to, so hopefully that will won't get so late.
Indeed.
See, I was looking at Chris for the Lamaze class.
I guess you're not settled.
Stop moving.
Normally there's not that much movement on the couch, at least on camera.
A little bit of Chesterfield football on the couch.
Yeah. So why don't we move on, guys? We've got lots to get to on the show tonight. As I said, we're going to be doing the Murdertron giveaway. We're going to give away a t-shirt. What is Murdertron, guys? Murdertron designed this for us. This is a bastardization of our logo and their logo, which looks fabulous on a t-shirt.
It's a marriage.
They married the two logos together. They really didn't bastardize it.
So basically, Murdertron, guys, is a company that does paintball casual wear. So if you're looking for something to wear off the field that still represents paintball, check them out at Murdertron, and you can find them on their Facebook page as well. We'll give you more information as we go on. Casting call, guys, if you want to put in anything to the show, pictures, video, anything like that, send it in to show@behindthebunker.com and we can get your videos on the air. But remember, if you're doing videos, guys, keep them short, keep them sweet, keep them interesting. Otherwise, none of us remember what we're talking about.
Yes.
A little bit of ADD on our panel.
Yes.
World Cup, guys, is this weekend. Fantastic. Joe and I are leaving after the show. A limo will be picking us up and taking us to a private hangar to where our jet will be taking us to sunny Florida. So guys, we'll be down there doing all kinds of coverage. If you happen to see us down there, please do stop us and say hello. We'll have stickers in our pockets and maybe other goodies, maybe little candies to give away as well.
So you got to reach in and grab it yourself.
Yes. So definitely come in, stop in and say yes. And then here's what we were just talking about before the panel. Now, next Monday night, guys, we will be in Florida. We will do a show from Florida. It won't be a full-on show. It'll just be sort of a recap of what we saw at World Cup, something really casual. But on Thursday, when we get back,
Wednesday.
No, Wednesday's Halloween. I didn't realize. So we're going to have to do it Thursday because I do not want to do it on Halloween. So we'll do it on Thursday night next week, guys. We're going to have a full-on show. We're going to have World Cup. We're going to have all our regular guests. We're going to have a huge show. So check that out. And then the following week, we'll be back back as normal on Monday. Empire is releasing all kinds of new stuff at World Cup, much like this. This is the new Contact Zero gear. We're looking forward to seeing that next week. Obviously, Empire is one of our sponsors and really looking forward to seeing that. Now, speaking of Empire, I don't know if you guys have seen this picture that's going around. This is the new mystery gun. Dustin, you've had a chance to look at that. What do you think?
No, that's my new rain sleeve.
That's the closest. I hadn't seen it that close. It actually is taped. It looks like a spy car.
It does. Can we go back to it as much as I want to look at Dustin?
It looks like a DM.
See, I thought it looked like a Lux because there's no macro line. And the shape of it sort of does. Now, the tape on the back obviously has done that to fool us with the shape of it.
I think the body's too big to be a Lux-style body, though.
Maybe they brought the Omen back.
Now, that was a shocker.
I believe that picture was taken as Damian Ryan, and as we know from Damian, he has mini Oompa Loompa fingers. So maybe the gun is actually big.
He's got pretty manicured-looking fingernails.
He sure does. Behind the Bunker giveaway. What are we giving away?
What?
I don't remember. But you know what? Headbands, guys. We were talking. Oh, that's what we're talking about. Headbands. These are the new Behind the Bunker headbands that are coming up. They're fully full graphics.
Boom!
Yeah, or we might have them in purple. We're not sure yet.
Boom!
I like purple personally.
That is in your face.
Who's doing that for us and how we're getting them? We'll all tell you starting next week. Animal, who has that press release? You have the press release.
Gavin?
I do.
Would you share it?
I sure would. For those of you who can't make it to Cup, there is a contest by Animal Paintball. And the contest is appropriately named, I Couldn't Make It to Cup Giveaway. And they understand that not everybody can make it to Cup, and they would like to give away a custom tournament jersey. And the way that you can get this custom tournament jersey is you just need to take a picture of yourself and your paintball gear doing something other than playing paintball and tag it on Facebook. And they'll be giving away a pre-made, one-of-a-kind Animal Customs tournament jersey every day of World Cup.
Nice.
Crazy!
Now, Jimmy Fett in the chat is wondering when we're going to have Behind the Bunker Shemas. Maybe that'll be a project.
That's
for...
That's a scenario version. We actually have our friends in Afghanistan, and a little small sand hut outside of Kabul are actually, they're weaving them right now in green and blue.
Very nice. Patches. This is a picture that I caught from Patchworks. This is Greg Red Hastings trying to steal some of the patches from Patchworks display there at the, I'm not going to pronounce it right, but the Vectoring game in France. So. Look at all those selections. If you guys are looking for team patches that look really cool, fit on your jerseys, your vests, all that sort of stuff, check them out. You can see them on our Facebook page.
In their vestibule.
Nice. Why don't we move along, guys? We have tons of stuff to get to on the show tonight, as I mentioned. We have all kinds of videos. We're already running long, unfortunately, so we're going to see how we get to them. But let's start with our first segment, Matt. We decorated for question time. So guys, if you have a question, send it into show@behindthebunker.com and we will try and get it answered on the air. Dustin, what do we have on for this evening?
First email I have here is from Chris Simuskas. He's saying, I just seen the new GI gear pod pack, which looks nice, and it goes along with their pods that they recently released. I can't remember what kind of pods, but this is for another time. I have a slight disadvantage with my wrist. I have two screws in my left wrist and until it comes time to put a plate in there. Leaves it to where I have a hard time bending the wrist and able to reach a pod pack fast enough. However, it made me think of this question. What kind of pod pack would you recommend to someone with a similar problem?
He sounds like RoboCop with all his bionics. I don't know. Does anyone else want to take this one? I have a thought now, but does anyone else want to, Josh?
Deer in what style of play? How serious do you want to
wreck? That's the first question.
Speedball, or maybe he just gets a two-pod pouch and wears it in front to protect his package.
But it's not speedball. It can go to a vest. I don't know. It's just like it's something you got to try and fool around with. It really speaks to sort of accessibility, and it's just like it's as much as everybody. I mean, nobody experiences this on the counter. at the panel here. So I don't know. It's just one of those things you're gonna have to go try different stores and try stuff on.
For sure. Now, one thing I would suggest is now this is for me. I enjoy wearing a speedball type harness because I'm not a fan of wearing things in my front. But if I were to wear a speedball harness, if I were you, and suggest it, I would find one. There's one that I'm thinking of specifically. If you go to Empire and ask them for a hinge pack, for two reasons. First of all, when you put your pod in a hinge pack, it's so tight to get your pod in because as soon as you undo the flap, it pushes your pod out at least 2 or 3 inches, which makes it very easy to grab your pod and yank it down. Sometimes it's so powerful it'll actually shoot your pod right out, so you have to be quick with those. The other reason why I like those is, and I know you've got a hard time with your wrist, but with a hinge pack, you can actually open the hinge on the side and swing your whole pack to your side and manually load it yourself and then swing it back around. So check out Empire's hinge pack. I think that would be a good option, or any pack from any company that allows for the pod to drop out real fast, which will expose the pod for you to grab your hand.
But that's, I mean, it lends itself to pulling it out, but I mean, if you're not throwing it in tournament play and you have to stick it back, it's one of those things where you have to, the hinge pack may sound like a better option.
Yeah. You can put little strings on each of your pods and you don't have to pick them up, and as you walk back, then you can just
forget it. Like, get a dump pouch.
Kind of like mittens.
A dump pouch, yes, like mittens. In Canada, we have mittens with strings on them for when we go to the sugar bush.
Because that's all we do is brew maple syrup. Let's move on to the next question. What else do we have, Dustin?
Hey guys, I might be buying a TM7. I was wondering what your opinions are on the gun. I am fairly new to the sport and want a general purpose gun.
A general purpose gun. You guys are big on the TM series guns. What do you think?
I like them. I think it's great for close quarters combat. With the stock, you can get a little bit longer play out of it. I'm a big fan of the TM series.
Yeah. The barrel, it's cock or threaded, so barrel options are nearly limitless. Get a rip clip as well. Spend your extra $40, $50, $80, whatever rip clip costs, wherever you are. Put that on. It's a great electronic feeding system. I would recommend it. And they're black, so you can really dress them up with pearls.
Now, Josh, you have a TM gun, don't you? You have the 15, right?
I have the 15 7. And the 7, actually.
Nice. What are your thoughts? Now, keep in mind, though, the question is, guys, he's new to the sport. Is this a good gun? Is it going to be too complicated?
There's going to be a certain learning curve with it because it is a spool valve marker. If you're willing to put in the time and the effort to getting to know the operation of the gun, then it could be a worthwhile investment.
I think it's pretty user friendly, though.
It is pretty user friendly.
If you're not willing to, I mean, if you're not going to try to squeeze all the performance out of it and tinker around with it, if you don't muck around with it, I mean, it'll be great out of the box.
Yeah. Just play with it. Don't touch it until something goes wrong.
It's not as bad as the autocockers used to be for the messing around with factor.
But they were amazing.
The autocockers were great. But here's the problem. When I see a new kid coming into the store and they say, listen, I want a new gun, the first thing I do is I try to steer them away from electronic guns, because with a battery comes programming issues, which comes boards, which becomes other options. I usually try and suggest getting into something like a mechanical gun. Now, if he wants a TM7, what are we talking about that's a mechanical equivalent that may not have electronics in?
Mech A5.
Yeah, you can also go to the Phenom, or it's
Phenom X7.
Yeah. So I don't know, that's just some other suggestions.
You got a pump gun.
A pumpkin. It is the season.
That's right. Now, yep. With that comment, Dustin, you had a question about a pump tonight, didn't you?
About a pump gun?
Not a pumpkin, a pump gun.
A pump gun, eh?
Sometimes called jack-o'-lanterns if you carve them.
Well, I can see the answer already.
It's I don't really have
for the Empire Sniper, and you haven't put your cocking rod back in correctly. That's why it's rubbing against the body.
It's a poppet valve. Apparently. You said spool valve because you're
very
thinking
good.
Like
well, you know what? While Dustin's digging up these questions, why don't we move on, guys? Tonight's topic of the show is, if you could actually put a number on how many times you've played paintball, what would that be? Now, one of our gentlemen that send in videos all the time, Colonel Mustard, sent this in. Let's see what he has to say.
Hey, guys. Please. What's up? Colonel Mustard here. I know I put on a little bit of weight since the last time you've seen me. It's been, well, they've been running a lot of good special items at Golden Corral, and I've been eating there like every day for the past 2 weeks. But I've got some really great news for you all. I'm actually this next week starting a whole new career. I'm ditching paintball. I know it's kind of sad, but I'm getting into airsoft, and I think airsoft's really just much more exciting. And with the money I want to be saving on paint, I'll be able to play a whole lot more. So look for a lot of great videos coming from me. I'm also going to be getting into Pokemon. And
hey guys. What are you doing with my camera?
I was just working on stuff.
Really?
Yeah, I was working on stuff.
You're fixing the air bunkers?
Well, there's stuff over there that needs to be screwed.
Guys, this is my good friend Mike. Whatever you just said, it's probably true. Can we get Mike in the air?
Hey guys, what's up? Colonel Mustard here. I know I put on a little bit of weight since the last time I talked to you.
Get him in frame, Randy. Get him in frame.
That was awesome.
Restart the recording.
That was awesome.
Yeah. All right. So well done, Colonel Mustard. That was good. Yeah. Gavin.
Hi.
Hi. How are you enjoying the show this evening?
I think it's fantastic. And I would like the show to continue. And I'd like to watch it every week. But the only way that that's possible, folks, is if you, here comes the begging portion of the show, support the show. We have two packages to support and let people know in the paintball community that, hey, I love to watch paintball on Monday nights. And you can support this show by buying a support package. We have the regular support package for $34.99, t-shirt, barrel sock, stickers, and a deluxe package support package for $44.99, which includes everything in the first package but the addition of a 3D patch.
Ooh,
from Patchvix. And it's fantastic, and all the ladies love them. And you need to support the show by getting a support package. And if you already purchased a support package and are looking for more ways to help the show out, there's also the
chip in fund.
Folks. So empty your PayPal account into there, and if you do a contribution of $500 or more, Todd will throw in a tote bag.
I don't have tote bags.
Wait till we get our first $500 donation, then we'll throw together something.
If a plastic grocery bag equals a tote bag, then I have.
Nobody said what's in
those.
The tote bag, but you will receive a tote bag.
Could it be a PBS pledge drive tote bag?
I have a PBS t-shirt I think I'll wear one.
That'll go in the tote bag, or just the bag.
Tote.
I only have one package. Moving on, Matt, why don't we move on to the next segment? Alright, so on the road, guys, behind the bunker, you can find them this upcoming weekend at World Cup. Joe and I will be there.
I'm Joe.
And lots of people that have been through the show will be there as well. So come in and see us. We'll have stickers available for you. And if you want anything in the support package, those t-shirts or barrel bags, go to Valken's booth and you'll be able to purchase any of that stuff over there.
Paintball long and prosper.
Yeah. Also, this upcoming weekend, we have Skeletor, who is going to be the general of the American Blue Team at West Point. No, that was us past weekend.
Oh,
so
Skeletor.
You probably missed him. He was at West Point this past weekend.
So take back
my
the
mistake.
Yeah, so Skeletor going to go to World
how
Cup.
How would
who us
sound backwards?
Fold
the Gap coming up November 8th. You will see myself and A-Train, Colonel Mustard, and a whole bunch of people down for that in North Carolina. So check that out. Rogue Elf at Flag Artist Paintball, November 25th. You'll see entire panel there. Basically, everybody in the studio will be there because it's the closest field to us. And if you'd like to come up for an awesome pre-winter game, come check that out.
Man, for a great cause.
It's a charity game.
Charity
well,
game. It's not
it
just
is.
Running
it
around.
It is. So, we have Andy in the studio this evening.
Right over here.
Hey!
Chilling on the Airups.
How is Airups a German company?
I think Patchwork threw him right.
I'm playing.
Airups. Und Airups.
Airups.
Patchwork und Airups.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Some people.
So, guys, Andy had an opportunity to, let's call it a documentary, I guess, Andy?
Yeah, a mini doc was...
A mini doc. He put something together to basically ask the question, is paintball, when you play paintball, is that actually fitness? Is that a physical activity that is worthy of activity? The video is about 10 minutes long. Yes, thank you, Gavin. I basically went in a circle on that one. It's about a 10-minute long video. Andy's narrowed it down for a minute just to show you a quick highlight of it. We're going to put the video, the full video, on our Facebook page tonight and again tomorrow so you guys can check it out. This is a great video. Well, you know what? Why don't you check it out and we'll come right back and talk about it. We are now.
Paintball. To the initiated, a pursuit of passion. But in this age of an obesity epidemic, does paintball count as exercise? Can this sport be recognized as a camouflaged path to health? Or will it remain misunderstood to the public as simply recreation for the weekend warrior?
All right. Hopefully they didn't hear that last comment.
What?
Just in case.
If you're watching a rewind, you may have to go back. I don't
it's
know
a romantic couch.
So Andy, Mark for Fitness, tell us a little bit about.
Well, the project came out of a larger project, which is just to expose the community to things that are fun, accessible, and qualify as exercise as well. And it actually came out of one of sort of a conversation with somebody and more of a debate. You know, paintball, oh, it's a big video game, it's got nothing to do with exercise. And I said, you know, well, hang on a second here, it's got all the elements of exercise. So we started with the interview with Dr. Laura, she's not on the trailer, but a PhD from University of Waterloo, and basically explains what the difference between physical activity, which is just basic human movement, and something that qualifies as exercise. And then, of course, from there, we got a chance to have two, I don't know where I'm pointing, oh, no, this way. Two very famous local paintball experts on there, and just to share the sort of the story of getting involved from the street level for the purpose of exercise, or if you're already involved, how you play the game is as important to the benefits that you reap from it. So that's kind of the short story. The long story is a little more complicated, but it was so much fun to do. We had such a blast.
Yeah, for sure.
And to whoever hit me in the junk with my camera, I'm coming for you next year. They're gonna hook me up, and I'm gonna come find you for sure.
In his defense, I told him it was a 3D movie. So,
bang.
Mm-hmm.
But now your film was one of the finalists at the Grand River Film Festival as well. So it's one of the four finalists that I'm over. 60 submissions, is that right?
Yeah, that was really cool actually, because it started as part of the television program, The Active City, as what was supposed to be just a 5-minute segment, go play paintball. And it just, Gavin's commentary on what he plays and Joe's historical context really just blew it up into sort of that 10-minute thing that's online. And then that was picked up by the Grand River Film Festival. So seeing it in the theater was awesome and just sort of opened our eyes that this is a great topic, not only what qualifies as exercise, but what qualifies as something that really, makes life worth living. And certainly, I mean, you guys with your community here can see that, it's something that makes you want to get up in the morning and inspires you to move, and what more can you ask for, right? So yeah, like I said, how you play the game is super important, and just loving playing the game, you run a little harder and it actually qualifies as exercise.
Now, here's a question, and I know people are going to be asking this as well. Because you, Andy, have been on the paintball field, you've been using your equipment, that it looks really good. Now, I also noticed that you had used some GoPro style cameras out there for some of your interviews.
For sure.
We get asked all the time, what is our recommendation for a great paintball camera that's safe to use on the paintball field? Maybe you can answer some of those questions.
Yeah, sure. It really depends on what you want to do. I mean, if you just want to see, you want to see somebody that you marked and you want to review it after, then cameras like the R7's awesome. The contour. I personally used a GoPro, and but they all have similar frame rates. They all have similar features on them, like one button startups and things like that. For me, it was a combination of using a Sony RX cam that I put a flak jacket on and filters, because I did get tagged in the camera a couple times. So $70 filter saved a few $1,000 camera, and Canon 7D. So most people have some sort of DSLR. So if you want to share your paintball story. There's so much, it's so easy to do, and there's editing software to do that, but any one of those three cameras I mentioned, you can get some cool stuff.
I will say, though, I've watched your documentary several times online, I've shared it with a lot of people, but we went to the actual preview of it at the Grand River Film Festival and watched it on a real theater, on a real-size movie screen, and I have never had more nightmares seeing Joe at 17 feet wide.
Oh, that was
just
awesome.
Just his cranium, and Gavin, you were quite mammoth with you, but it was
for
fantastic.
Once in my life, I was huge.
You're huge, impending.
Yeah, it was really good. And you know what, guys? This video is great. I would definitely post it up for any of you that have friends that play paintball. This is great. And if you're trying to get people or solicit people to come out to play paintball, this is a good video that shows it too. And I'll tell you one thing too. We're at this Grand River Film Festival, and it's a room full of
film guard.
Can I be blatantly honest?
Bunch
of artsy snobs. Okay, there are a lot of guys that are film people.
And the contest is over at this point,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah. Yeah. The contest is over. So I was really interested to see how people that obviously never played paintball. Most of them, I would say, 99% of the people in that room probably never played paintball, just by the way they were in that room. But when they watched that video, I watched not only the video but I watched the crowd, and people were. You could hear them. You can hear them sort of groan when the one guy got hit, and you could see that they were all captivated. And it may not have been their forte, but you definitely captured their interest, and it was very well done.
I want to say thanks to Andy, sort of an outsider of the community, coming in and shooting it, and it's so well done. Normally, you see videos produced for paintball players for paintball players. It's a very different flavor, so I like this. It was sort of the layman. It catered and appealed to a large market. And I really want to thank Andy for that, because I think it really fairly represented our sport and a great image. And so, again, thank you, sir. Yep.
You're welcome, fantastic. Guys. It was a blast, and I got the feeling it's not the first one.
Good. Yes, we hope to have more paintball projects coming out
for
of
sure.
You. So.
Yeah.
Now, our friend Wolf just asked what film it was. Wolf, I sent you the link last week for you to have a look at it. It's that 10-minute long video. Watch it and post it on your site. It's just awesome.
Yeah.
It's one of the few paintball movies or videos that I've watched in its entirety on at least three separate occasions, other than anything you make, Wolf, or Cat Jack. Pardon?
Okay, second to Bobby Deuce.
Bobby Deuce.
That
really
does not even count.
Yes, it does.
He's playing like paintball with like action figures.
Shit, that's enough.
Yeah.
It counts.
So we're going to move on, guys. We have still a lot to get to over the course of the show. First of all, I want to say thank you to Paul. I'm not going to give away his last name, but Paul, thank you. He was the latest person to purchase a support package this evening. Thank you very much, sir.
Hooray! Thank you, Paul.
Why don't we move on? When we come back, we have more questions. We have lots more videos, so stay tuned, guys.
Hello.
So this week's topic is how many times you've ever played paintball. So let's see. A lot. That's just an estimate.
So Player of the Week, guys, if you know someone who you think is deserved to be on our show as Player of the Week, send me a picture of them, a decent one this time, and a write-up of why you think they should be nominated, and we will get them on the show. Just send it in to show@behindthebunker.com. Now, Murdertron, guys, we were going to give away this t-shirt. Here's what we're going to do. You don't need to do it right this second, but anytime over the course of the week, I would like you to post up on Murdertron's Facebook page the answer to this simple question. We were talking to Andy on the couch just a minute ago. I would like to know, what was the name of Andy's video? Very nice.
Ooh, that's a good one.
Yeah. That's a very good question.
Yeah. Very good question. Yeah. See if you're paying attention. I had to turn the lights on and off a couple times because you weren't listening. So there you go. So put that up on the Murdertron Facebook page, and we'll mention that again over the course of the show. So, Chris.
Yes?
How would you like to take us on a journey? Chris
sure.
likes to show us a paintball field from somewhere around the world.
I do.
Where are you taking us this evening, Chris?
Colorado, as a matter of fact. Yes.
Nice.
I know, right? Well, it wasn't really an open-ended question.
Get to it.
Colorado, we are traveling. So, APC, they are Colorado paintball leaders when it comes to birthdays, company outings, and team building, bachelor parties, youth group outings, or just a day of fun. They offer both indoor and outdoor paintball fields. Their indoor paintball and laser tag field is conveniently located in the Denver, while their outdoor paintball and airsoft fields are located in Brighton, Colorado, and are open Saturday and Sunday year-round. Their indoor location also offers a fully stocked Denver paintball store on site. They carry a large selection of paintball markers and a full selection of Dye, JT, Empire, and Spider paintball gear. But wait, APC is amping things up. They are renovating their 65-acre outdoor location into 14 different playing fields all in one. Their indoor location now hosts a concession stand selling a large variety of snacks, drinks, pizza, and much more. They have also added a laser tag to their fields with new technology that connects directly to the paintball marker and gives an opportunity for the spectators as well as younger kids to play while still giving the paintball sound and feel. Whether you're looking for a fun day out or a more challenging scenario experience, APC has the right game for you. Next time you're in Colorado, be sure to check them out.
Is it close to the Denver?
Chris, you got the Video of the Evening Award.
Nice. Very good.
I feel like that already happened this evening once.
If you guys would like to be featured on Chris's segment, we can't call you Paintball Around the World. We're going to separate this.
Play while you stay.
Play while you stay. Nice. If someone out there would like to come up with a bumper for play or an intro for Play While You Stay,
I would like to know where you're staying. I think Colorado.
What hotels are around?
Okay. Did you do that research?
You know what? I'll be honest with you. I had a busy week at school, and I didn't happen to get to the map quest. I was hoping people would just let
muffin.
Me slide on by.
So today's segment is just play.
You know what? Play. What's up with that, Gavin? I just tried to have a good segment, and you had to pick it apart. Play. What's up with that?
Is that anywhere near where the original Red Dawn was filmed? In Colorado.
There you go.
Yes. I don't know.
Yes,
you know
was.
What? They gave me an address.
Wolverine!
They gave me a feature. Oh, they didn't mention Red Dawn. They didn't mention MapQuest or any other.
All right, you've had your mic.
Fine.
Say yes.
So. Dustin, turn his mic off now.
Moving on, guys. A couple other quick things I want to talk to you about. Casting call, guys. Get your videos, get your submissions into show@behindthebunker.com. Get your stuff on the air. If you would like to know next week's discussion, we are talking about... if you could figure... Oh, no, that
was the one thing you would change in the sport of paintball.
If there was one thing... Thank you, it was right on my sheet.
Yeah,
if there was one
top.
Thing that you could change in the sport of paintball, what would it be? So get your submissions in next week. This picture has been floating around the paintball world on people's Facebook page. It's been on The Nation. It's been all over the place. Basically, what this gentleman did was he used oil on his regulator, on his high-pressure air tank, and inevitably blew it out. You can see the destruction of his hand there as well as the tank.
No slow clap on that one.
No slow clap.
It looks like the clap.
I'm not sure if you know what the clap looks like.
I don't know.
But, so guys, just another warning we keep telling you on the show. Please do not use oil.
Always wear a glove.
No oil.
Yeah. thank you. Splatmaster. Who has the write-up on the Splatmaster? Dustin, you had something you want to talk about?
I do. These
Darwinism, yes.
This weekend.
Made an appearance at the Patriot Games.
What?
They were out trying to grow awareness for the sport. They were out with all the Boy Scouts of America, and they were in Fort Knox, Kentucky, with over 10,000 scouts in attendance. It was the main attraction with over 1,100 scouts, nine years old, participated in this 7-hour event.
Some Boy Scouts.
Yeah. Those are cool.
So basically, they got a chance to play with the Z200 shotgun, which is a spring-loaded, low-impact paintball. And they got to be instructed by professional paintball players Nicky Cuban and Thomas Taylor to learn how to play and the benefits of playing paintball.
So pump, shoot, run, wipe. Pump, shoot, run, wipe. I'm just kidding. Oh, I'm just kidding.
Nicky or Thomas?
Speaking of Bobby Dukes.
And sadly, the tent was stolen again, too, right?
Yes. Yes, it was.
This seems to be a recurring theme.
Hey, we got one of those.
So, guys, we're going to move on. We have more videos to get to.
Did you find it cheap on eBay?
We're going to talk about, again, tonight is if you could put a number on how many times you played paintball, what would it be? Now, this video comes all the way from Johannesburg. This is Snarky. Let's see what he has to say.
Todd? Todd! This week's question is a pointless, purposeless question. So I'm going to troll you. You guys in the chat room, in the Ustream chat room, if you think it's a pointless question to ask all the video contributors how many times have you played paintball, say Snarky is right. So Todd, to answer your question, how many times have I, Snarky, played paintball? 0!
Alright, well done, Snarky, but I have to say all the
people in the chat forum that are listening to Snarky, Dustin, you get the band sticker on over there, right? Very nice. Alright, so what was it that you were going to say, Dustin?
Alright, I have a shout out for Justin_LPN, who's watching tonight. He's live feeding us to their website as well, which is beta.localpaintballnews.net. He PM'd me and actually said that he had to take a petition at work, so that to allow them to be able to watch a show. And I asked him where they worked, and he works for the USAF, so the United States Air Force.
Hey.
Yay!
Well, hold on a second before you guys get all high and mighty. First of all, what was his name?
Justin_LPN.
Okay, Justin, this is copyright material. You can't be going and using my stuff. I'm just kidding. Thank you very much.
Chipping fun.
Very nice, thank you.
Can you get us an F-18?
And you know what? Anybody out there that has a website that would like to have Behind the Bunker embedded on their site, send me an email. I'll give you the embed code, and you can have it streamed to your site so that you could drive traffic to your website to watch the show. And while they're there, maybe they'll check out your chip at Widgeon or support package.
I have a down comforter on my embed.
Oh, nice. Is that on top of the rubber sheet, or?
Oh, God. What's that?
That's coming up soon. Wait till you see on What's Up With That.
No,
coming up soon.
No, what's up with you?
Not at all.
Jeez. Moving on tonight, guys. Let's move into next feature.
I should have showed up at rehearsal. It is the team feature this week, and the featured team comes out of a place where people play paintball frequently, and they are Jersey Instinct. And this team may come from New Jersey, and they have some great instincts to play the sport of paintball. So great job, guys. You are the featured team of the week, and I enjoy your flags.
Okay, that's Ron. That's Ron from Jersey Instinct, and they were recently at a camp out, and they played a 24-hour game, and they set up their tent. It's a geodesic dome tent. There they are at the skirmish field.
This is actually their 12-inch album cover that they released back in 1978. This is Songs of the Field.
And the title trial track was Skirmish. Mm-hmm. We'll All Invade. And there we are back at their tent. You can see the tent area has grown. And
yeah. That was a tent hat he was wearing.
They ski. That's a hat. A toque.
Very nice. And there's Kim Mitchell.
Sebastian Bach.
Sebastian Bach. All right, guys, let's cut this now to embarrass them. Listen, guys, I have to apologize. I have other information that I left at my desk at home, and I apologize. So we'll have to rerun that next week with the proper information, although I think we probably made them a little more interesting anyway.
So. I'm sure the sponsors appreciate that plug.
Yes, that one was free, boys. They're sponsored by Neat.
Well, it says here they're sponsored by Ovaltine, so I'm not sure how that works out. So thank you, Jersey Instinct. We will get you back on next week.
I'm hoping that's your team name.
Yes, and Gavin will get his things straightened out. So guys, why don't we move on to...
Where are we?
Oh, what's that? Oh, sure.
Do I gotta go?
Andy's got to go, guys, on the couch.
Turn
to
a pumpkin.
Thank you very much, Andy, for being in the studio. Oh.
Thank you, guys. It's a pleasure.
What would you like to... where can people find that video or find more information about you?
I guess the big deal is you can go to activecambridge.ca or YouTube/activecambridge, and the point is that after you're done watching Behind the Bunker on your comfy Air-Ups couch, get off said Air-Ups couch and go do something. And if it's something is painful, go to Flag Ridge, put your R7 on, go film it, put it online, share the story, get other people moving. Thanks a lot for having me, guys. That was awesome.
Thanks, Andy.
So while we're saying our goodbyes to Andy, why don't we move on to our next segment?
Hi there, welcome back to Custom Corner. My name's Joe, I'm from Flag Ridders Paintball, and here at Behind the Bunker, every week we ask for submissions for Custom Corner. That's where you've modified, customized, painted, modified, or done anything to your gear. Our first one comes to us from Joseph Lemieux, cousin of Mario Lemieux, the famous Pittsburgh Penguin hockey player. He has sent us a modified JT Team Estastic Splatmaster. He's taken the spring above the trigger out to turn this thing into a hair trigger. It's got a custom paint job, an NC Star LED red dot sight. This thing shoots 50 caliber Splatmaster rounds like no one's business. Moving right along to our next submission. This comes to us from Ian Spector, Ian S.
Custom edition.
It's a Tippmann crossover the die rotor and a Milsig K series with a hollow point and tactical flashlight. He also has a box mag for the Milsig. Thanks, and he loves the show.
He loves it so much that he actually got a support
pack.
A deluxe one. It's got a BBD on it.
That's right. That is the limited edition yellow sticker.
And Ian also has an iPhone. Moving right along, this comes to us from Matthew White.
Oh, geez.
Please see attached photo of his custom Jordan White's custom paintball mask. It's a standard paintball mask, and he's overlaid it with latex mask and took a lot of time and a lot of hot glue. Good job for you.
Hot what on his latex?
Hot glue on his latex glue.
As long as he's not using petroleum products.
And next comes to us from Long Hair. At Flaggers Paintball, he's a member of the Task Force Raider Juniors, and he was filming an episode of Weeds recently. So good for him, and thank you very much. And it's true, the sky is always blue at Flaggers. Next comes to us from Troy Smith. He's sniping with his new Milsig M Series Paradine Pro Magwell at Magwell Shooter Games Op 2. Good for him. Very nice. Nice job, nice custom. Thank you for your submission.
Mag Fed, next wave of the future.
Uh-huh.
Like bottom it or not, it's going to be
magazine.
Hot.
Bottom feed magazine.
Now,
next.
Zuby.
Zuby has a...
Would you like to introduce your video?
Zuby does.
Yes, I did a fantastic video from Area 51 with the great folks out there. Fantastic field, great group of people out there. If you're in Michigan, go check it out.
Oh, very nice. Now, nice. Can I make a question here? Is it true that the music that was done in the background, was it actually the guitar stylings of Bram from Sharon Lawson Bram?
It's actually the guitar stylings of
Ted Nugent's
Behind the Bunkers
from Behind the from Detroit
area, track 21.
Ah, let's check it out. Nice.
Hey Zuby.
What's up, Connie? Welcome to Custom Corner.
Hey, I just want to show you I got my very first paintball gun that got me into the game.
It's a beautiful looking piece. Tell me about it.
Well, I started in about 95.
Alright, so tell me what we got here.
Well, I started paintball back in 95 and John and I were really into making ourselves known, so we made ourselves a couple crazy guns. This one's mine. Yeah. I got my hopper custom painted by D-Maniac.
Old school Revy.
Old school Revy, still works.
Look at that.
Had an auto body shop custom paint some gold flake car paint on it. It's got a shock tech removable bolt and one of the first carbon fiber barrels ever made. I put so many paintballs through that, the entire insides are worn out.
That's a lot of paintball.
Gun still works good though.
Awesome. If you're watching Behind the Bunker, this has been Custom Corner.
Welcome to Paintball. All right, stop it. It's trademarked.
Oh.
Paintball around the world. If you have anything that you'd like to add to the show, it's...
But if you do it backwards,
send it to show@behindthebunker.com. First poster we have up for this evening is November 3rd. The Black Hawk Down game is going on. The Vulcan Core will be there. Be sure to check it out. Big Indian Paintball. Blast Camp Zombie Game happening October 28th. The Crusades is coming to Europe in 2013. Check out their website for more details.
Shoreline.
Shoreline Paintball, yes.
Those are swords hitting each other.
Mobster Redemption is November 3rd and 4th. Fort Knox Paintball.
Shane.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? November 17th is the Sniper Challenge at Camp X. Zombie versus Humans happening October 27th at Low Country Paintball.
I'm sure Low Country appreciates when we do that.
Yes, I'm sure they do. Foldagap. A few people from Behind the Bunker, as well as some people contribute, will be there. It's sure to be
That's
a great
like
time.
People.
Be November 9th. I'm sure there'll be a little bit of shenanigans going on there.
Come see Smash.
Smash.
Take on me.
Yeah, take on Todd on a 1v1. OXCC Battle of the Bulge, Breakout of Baston, happening December 8th. Streamfield at Chesapeake, Maryland City.
Very nice, thank you.
You're welcome.
Okay. Thank you.
Yes.
Where's this? This is new.
Tag Brag Africa Cup, and this is happening in Johannesburg on December 1st and 2nd.
Maybe Snarky will cover some
what
of that.
What type of payment is accepted?
Probably Rands, which is the accepted currency in South Africa.
Very nice.
DC versus Marvel happening
Marvel?
November 4th. Yes, on Marvel's. The Marvel's in my mouth. Long Live Paintball on November 4th. We Were Soldiers 2 happening November 3rd at Pirates Peak.
Now Escape more Nevada. Soldiery.
Now with more soldier, yes. Paintball Turkey Shoot going on November 3rd with the best chili in the world.
I want chili.
Normandy Revisited at Landing Zone Paintball December 10th. Landing Zone Paintball.
Where?
They have a very, very cool Normandy beach. And the Behind the Bunker logo on there. Look at that.
Nice.
I can see England across the channel.
Fantastic. You should be able to. Grid Fighters Tryout is happening October 27th at Frontline Paintball. PRZ is hosting one of the Aaron's Army Tour of Duties. D-Glock happening November 10th and 11th.
Duty. Informative.
That's very soon. And happening November 25th is Operation Rogue Elf at Flaggers Paintball. Join myself and Gavin and everyone here.
Do you have a poster for that, Josh?
No, I don't have a poster for that.
Can you work on that for next
is
week?
Is it in the budget?
I don't know.
Okay. We might have to do one for Red Dawn 8, which is also coming up on March 3rd.
I think it's Retaliation.
Retaliation?
But in Russian.
In Russian?
The way the
my Russian's rusty.
Miniature Retaliation.
Yeah. And we also have two videos from this evening, which we're not going to show.
Well, we're gonna not show them to basically bring you a couple other ones that were sent in. And this hot off the press, too. A good friend of mine, Charles Holton, has invited me via Facebook, so it's got to be important, to P&L Paintball Bridgewater for Ghost Town's annual Halloween big game. That's all I can see in my notifications. You'll have to stay tuned for next week until I can actually tell you more information about that. How's that for a teaser? Very good. Why don't we move on, guys? We're going to hit up next. We have Kachak to get to. We still have to talk to our friend Beaker. We still have Track 21 is sending us a great video in from Paintball Explosion. We have the vault coming up. Oh, yes. If we have time, we still have someone else sent in their own custom vault. As well as, if there's time, we still have the professor to get to, Bridgewater, Scraps sent in a video. We have, if there's time, we'll even show you a SAR 12 gun preview from Sonny Lopez, as well as a video that happened at Grid Fighters this year. Really well done video. But guys, we're running out of time, so let's keep the show moving and let's move right on into our friend Cat Chat. All right, guys, we are having some technical difficulties with Tomcat's sound. We will try and assess that in a moment. So why don't we move on, guys, let's check out the topic video that Beaker sent us in this week on how many times has he played paintball.
Hey, this is Beaker from Exiled Souls, member of Blues Crew. You're watching Behind the Bunker. This week's question was if I could count the games that I've played. There's just no way I can do that. I've been playing for a lot of years. There's been too many years to count and too many games to count. With my my kids, Kermit and Animal, I know they probably played about maybe between the both of them 20 games. Other than that, remember, this is Beaker from Exiled Souls, member of Blues Crew. You're watching Behind the Bunker, and yes, the hat will come back next week. Don't you forget that. Yeah, it's coming.
What's up, guys? Colonel Mustard here. I'm coming at you from PBC Greensboro. I'm here for a MagFed game held on by...
I'm Lee at Magwell. Magwell had the Shooter Games Op 2 today at Paintball Central. It was a real good day for paintball. Weather was awesome, and we had a great time.
If you guys don't know about MagFed, check out their websites, magwellpaintball.com.
MagwellPB.com.
You guys are watching
Behind the Bunker!
Good job, guys.
At Paintball Central, Greensboro, North Carolina, come see us. Yay!
What's up with that? Okay, folks, this is another one of these ones that I've been holding on to for a while, but I keep getting bumped. But now is my opportunity to shine.
Keep go, Gavin, go.
Lord, ladies and gentlemen, I gotta go really, really quick. This is something that completely grinds my gears. We're talking about unsafe products that are marketed towards our newbie scenario type player that may actually damage our sport. We're gonna show the video very shortly, but it's one of these things that makes me go, what's up with that? Matt, if you can play the video, we'll come back and discuss what really grinds my gears.
Is that your what's up with that?
What's up with that? These are the Army of Two masks that you can find on websites. Manufactured not for paintball, but being marketed for paintball and paintball games and airsoft and all that stuff.
No, those are high quality glasses hinge screws.
High quality, folks.
You know they're high quality because it's a Phillips head.
I can hit it with a hammer, and that keeps my eyes safe. Folks, these are not tested for paintball. You've already heard my opinion. I've leaked it out before going to the rest of the panel. If it's not designed for paintball, not tested for paintball, it should not make its way out of the playing field, regardless of how cool it looks. Unfortunately, those of us in the paintball playing community will know to stay away from this, but it's those new people who are starting out that I really worry about. I think this should be scrapped. I think there should be a campaign making sure that it never makes its way onto a playing field or even a renegade outlaw field, etc. So if you hear anybody about this, make sure you spread the word. Keep these crap off of your face.
You know, the problem is I saw those on eBay and they claim that they're safe for paintball and they don't say anything more than that. So, you know, I gotta admit, they are cool looking and I can see why people would buy them. But they ain't no paintball goggles. This is, how many young kids are buying those and going into the forest or going to their local field and playing with them? Okay, and you know what? Yes, the guy hit it with a hammer. And yes, he also hit a very brittle terracotta tile, which, yes, if you hit with anything, is going to shatter. But no, the goggle didn't. Guys, come on. Put some common sense out there.
And he's using a hammer with sandals.
I think one of the flip flops.
You know what? People show up at the field with those on occasion, and they want to wear them. And I say they're not approved, they're not rated. And I say so they're not approved. As the field owner, as a field operator, as a referee, you should have the final say in anything that's safety related at your field, and it should be your discretion. But I don't. I only allow certain goggles: JT, Empire, Sly.
Correct me if I'm wrong, but if a proper insured paintball field would not be able to allow them. They have to have an ASTM rating.
Gas masks and stuff like that. They're not designed for paintball. A tactical goggle is designed for a guy doing a dynamic entry. It's not designed to take the impact of a paintball.
Besides, would you believe a guy in a goggle or a mask trying to sell you that anyways?
No, he is. Clearly.
Yes, he's endorsing his product. He's using it anonymity. Yes.
Let's promote paintball safely.
So my concern is not the commercial fields, because I think proprietors and people who are in the industry want to continue to grow the sport. My concern is, once again, those renegade games, those backcountry games, at somebody's private land. You're not going to have the people there who are equipped to provide the safety, the first aid, anything that's required. So if you hear anybody see these, they're great for maybe your bedroom or running around the staging area.
Oh, for role playing.
For role playing, yes. Right. But make sure, for the love of Jehovah, that they do not make its way into a paintball field.
Who enjoys role playing, if you guys remember? There's a good trivia question.
Yes, that's the next week's Murdertron t-shirt question.
Very good. Actually, Chase Traffic said that he enjoys role-playing in his one video. Remember that? That's
yes.
A couple weeks ago. The bottom line is, guys, a couple weeks ago, just so that we clarify this, because I know I'm going to get emails about this. Yes, a few weeks ago, we played you a great video from a company called Aztec Paintball, and they make custom goggles for movie props, and they are paintball. He makes them specifically for paintball. But if you listen carefully, you'll also notice that both him and I profess that the ones that are designed for paintball are meant to fit over top of paintball goggles. He doesn't make goggles for paintball, he makes them to fit over paintball goggles. He also does make them for movies, and he had built-in sunglasses in the one. Those were for movies, but for paintball, he has paintball goggles that fit underneath. So just because I know I'm going
to
answer.
So there are companies out there. Do your research. Check with Behind the Bunker if you need to. That are not going to pose any safety risks. Still look cool for your scenarios, etc. But just make sure you know the products that you're getting.
Very good. Gavin, can we move on?
No, I guess okay. So.
Yes.
What happens if I have something that grinds my gears?
If something grinds your gears, jams your hopper, or gums up your barrel, send it to show at behindthebunker.com. If you have video, even better. Penicillin may cure some of that, but if a topic you'd like us to discuss, send us an email to the show, showbehindthebunker.com, and we will talk about it on What's Up With That?
Very nice. Now, guys, we had a little technical issue with CatCheck. We think we got it fixed. We're going to try it again. If it does not work, we will go right into, when it's finished, we'll go right into track 21. Paintball Explosion, he went to, and sent him this awesome video. So check this out, guys, and we'll be right back after CatCheck and track 21.
everybody. It's your boy A-Train for Track 21. Watch Behind the Bunker. Listen, we're out here at Paintball Explosion for the Clowns versus Zombies game. There's like 400 or 500 people here. It's insanely cool. Lots of gnarly gunfights, and there has to be. This place is an abandoned amusement park. Okay, if I can get Rob Leary from Ninja not to pull a bomb or shot. This event is totally cool because this place is an abandoned amusement park. Check it out.
Thanks, stupid. Stupid, see you later.
We're gonna go try to hunt some rattlesnakers.
Good day, y'all.
Don't call me babe.
Say Train Track 21 signing off from Clowns vs. Zombies. This is a really cool place. Ample parking, because in front of it's a parking lot. But check this place out. Put it on your to-do list.
Well done. Katchak, if you're watching, sorry buddy, we're going to see if we can fix it yet tonight. If not, we will put it on our Facebook page tonight for you guys to check it out. It was actually a really good one tonight. And if we don't get it on the show, we'll put it on our Facebook page tonight and over the next couple days so you guys get an opportunity to see it. Speaking of which, head on over to our Facebook page and like us. All of our videos go up there as well as our YouTube page. Go on over and subscribe. And tonight, head on over to Murdertron, guys. And the question we were wondering is... what is the name of the video of the gentleman, Andy, who was in earlier tonight that did for paintball? Now, SL Porno Magfed hits us up on the chat form and says, related to our topic, I wear a JT ProFlex without the soft ears because I wear over top of my ears a StyleCom headset. My ears are totally covered, though. What do you think about that, guys? What's your thoughts? Is that still keeping safe in the sport?
I think it's altering your mask the way it came from the factory, and therefore it wouldn't be covered as liability insurance. And you need to have ear protection while playing paintball, because that's what it's about. We're not in 1988 or 89 or 83, so you need protection that comes from the factory.
I think your comm system's designed for communications.
It's not designed for impact of paintballs or other projectiles. Leave your goggle system as it is intended, as Joe's saying, from the manufacturer. And if you need to, smaller communication for you. It's not designed for shots. It's not designed for hearing protection. So
you're, I would think you're not only that, you're setting an absolute terrible, terrible, terrible example for children that are coming to play this game.
You make children cry.
Stop it.
I'll play devil's advocate. I think it would look cool. I do agree that it would look cool, and I know no one's going to like this, but for airsoft, I would think that would be completely acceptable.
Mustard, he's an airsoft fanatic.
Most airsoft people barely wear paintball goggles. They usually wear something like tactical goggles instead. But for paintball, I don't know. If I got bunkered or shot at close range and it was in the ear, the comm, I don't know. That would be rather painful. But from Joe's standpoint, you're right. Like, that would not be insurable legally because you've altered the status of your goggle. Much like if you look at any tournament, you look at PSPN, PPL, or any major tournament series, if you quote-unquote alter your goggle, that's not keeping in with the tournament.
Not only that, is any other sport that you play, you can't go play football and say, well, yeah, they put a hockey visor on the front. It's the same thing. No, it's not.
Now, do all football people talk like that?
Yeah.
He responded back in the chat, eh?
That's what I'm pertaining to there. It's, it's for the Army, but you're just showing example for everybody else. Yeah, sure, go ahead and modify your goggles no matter what you want to do.
Chris, did you have a comment there? You had your hand up.
I thought we turned his mic off. He doesn't even have his phone on vibrate.
I'm feeling really lonely. It's terrible without a second person here. But I was just going to agree with the panel. I'm sure they're designed to protect you and you wear them in combat, but I argue the same question. Are they going to stop a bullet? Just because they're impact resistant doesn't mean, how do you test something like that? In the context of what if they slip, what if they come off your head? And like the panel said, you're setting a terrible example for new players too, because they may not have access to the same type of headsets that you do, and they're gonna go out to their local Radio Shack and get a $3 pair of RCA headphones.
Yes, I'm sure Cobra or Motorola will protect
your hearing. Yeah, but this keep in mind, if it's a military, even if it's military spec, Army surplus thing.
Right.
A guy wearing that is going into battle to risk his life in a live firefight situation. If he gets shot in the head and he's not wearing a ballistic rated helmet, it really is a moot point.
Exactly.
They need the specialized communications gear so they can communicate in specialized situations. Paintball is paintball. You need ear protection. Airsoft is different, maybe because you just need eye protection. But paintball needs air protection. The sport has evolved in nearly 30 years to where masks include ear protection and some have integrated fans. Keep it safe.
Now, guys, I'm going to move on because we still have a ton to get to. Matt Soseman in the chat, the live chat, wants to know how our show is going to go for next Monday after Cup. Well, first of all, Matt, you shouldn't be watching our show. Shouldn't you be practicing for Cup this weekend? And second of all, next week, we are going to do a live show, but it'll be Joe and I from our Florida compound. And we're not sure what the show is going to be like. We're going to try and put together a full-scale show if we can. Otherwise, we are going to do a full World Cup recap on Thursday next week. So stay tuned for that.
Two
as well.
Shows in 1 week?
Two shows in 1 week. This is good value. This is why you need to go to the bottom of your page. And much like, I'm not going to say the gentleman's name, but someone just went in and put $10 more in the Chip It widget down there. And not to sound like a PBS pledge drive, but thank you very much, guys. That money does go to pay our internet bills and stuff, and it does not go into our pocket. And it certainly doesn't go into our lush, lavish set either. But thank you very much for that. We're going to move on because we have the vault to get to. Joe, you have a vault this evening.
I do have a vault.
Why don't we check that out, and we'll come right back.
Hi, welcome back to From the Vault. My name's Joe. I'm from Flaggerters Paintball, and you're watching Behind the Bunker Live. Every week we go back in time, way, way back into the era of paintball when it first started. Today we're going to do a quick review of my Nelspot 007, first ever, really great condition paintball marker. These were out in the early 80s. This one's bolt action, 12 gram. And because of our request from many of our viewers, we're actually going to see if this gem will shoot. It's got a CO2 in it now. We'll degas it and we'll give it a go. But first of all, we're going to put on some goggles. We won't wear a pair of new E-Flexes, nor will we wear a pair of Spectras. We certainly will not wear a pair of original JTs with Ziplocs. We're going to have to go a little bit further back in time. We're not going to wear a UVX 9300 and a Woodstock mask, but we are going to go back in time and we are going to wear a pair of Norton 180 safety glasses, because this is all you wore in 1981 or 1982 when you played paintball. To change the CO2, we don't have high pressure air. It runs on a little 12 gram safety cartridge, which is, I remember we used to wear them in our underpants to keep them warm when we played in the fall. We'll throw a 12 gram in, 12 gram CO2. These are great back in the day because each cartridge had a little bit of lubrication in it, so it would naturally lubricate your marker. CO2 drops in, and then you finger twist it. This one's not bad. A little bit of a leak down the barrel, but some lubrication. Don't forget, this gun's nearly 30 years old, if not older, so if it is a little finicky, we'll see. It's bolt action, so you pull the bolt back like so, cock it, fire. Each time you do, but it's got a little leak. Let's put a reball in, see how it shoots in our handy dandy target range. We'll put 3 in because 3 is a magic number when you're playing paintball. So we're gonna put it forward. Hopefully a ball dropped in the breech. Good Lord. Remember, guys and girls, when you played paintball in 1981 or 82, you just shot that. That went halfway to Hamilton. And it shot. We didn't have chronographs, so you'd shoot a pop can and see what it would do. Evidently, if you were playing paintball in a t-shirt and wear a pair of safety goggles, you probably would not want to get hit by a paintball. But anyway, guys, Nelspot 007, excellent condition, little leak, but it does shoot. It is great. My name is Joe. I'm from Flaggeters Paintball, and you've been watching The Vault.
All right, very well done. Now, should we go to the question, or should we? You know what? Let's go to the question.
Do you have any questions for me about the gun?
Well, maybe that's what the questions were.
And then maybe we'll do a Zuby video.
Nice Justin, what you said you had lots more questions. What do you got for us?
Sure, I have a question here from Guillermo Nivas. Sorry about butchering your name, but...
Guillermo
Nivas. And he writes, "Hey guys, love the show. I'd like to try using a pump gun. Can you tell me which gun I should start with? A Zodin, or should I spend a little bit more on something? Thank you very much."
Good question.
Great question. That's a tough one. I gotta be honest with you, I've only shot an Azodin as I borrowed it from someone just to take a couple of shots, so I don't really know much about it. I can't say I've actually played many games with it. I think you're gonna get sort of a biased answer from us on the panel because I can speak for Gavin, I can speak for Joe for sure, that we're all advocates of the autococker from the old days. If you could find a used autococker.
Don't include me, I only have 3 of them.
I wasn't sure, I didn't want to overstep my bounds with Zuby because he'll eat me. But yes, I mean, we all have old autocockers. If you can find a used one to try it out, because you can get them fairly inexpensively right now, people don't realize that they're selling such an awesome piece of equipment. If you want something new, most of us up here are shooting the Empire Sniper just because it is an awesome gun. A lot of other people are using the T2, but again, these are high-end guns. So if you want to start into pump, I don't know if I'd...
Yeah. Yes, Joe?
There's a... Spider's got a new pump coming out, too. It's a mag-fed pump marker, so...
You mean a bottom-fed pump marker?
Bottom-fed pump...
Thank you.
Mag-fed, as opposed to like...
A magazine is something that holds multiple rounds, okay?
Hoffer's getting pretty angry tonight.
We'll get a picture of it. The Hammer 7. Yes, thank you, Blitzcamp.
Thank you very much. We had just had another person chip in another $10 on the chip at Widgeon, guys. Hey. Thank you very much.
Parker and Milo are mag-fed.
Yeah.
So to answer your question, if you can, whatever your budget is, if you can find a cheap pump gun used, fantastic. If not, if you're not sure if you're going to get into it, see if you can borrow one from a friend or...
Did Wolf hear that?
Yeah.
Guys, I'm also seeing CCI Phantom in the chat. Empire Sniper, the Azodin is also being hailed really
Sheridan.
Well. Sheridan is a little retro for you, but do your research. If you want to get into pump seriously, I would try it out a couple times first. It is a huge learning curve, and it's rather frustrating the first few times that you play it. But honestly, if you can stick with it, you will be by far a better paintball player if you can be proficient at pump.
And you make your showers better.
I think that's the best advice, just to, not Joe's advice, but just to stick with it. As Todd said, there's a learning curve to it, and it's a humbling experience the first time you play it, so you just stick with it.
Yeah, for sure. Keep pumping.
All
right. So why don't we move on, guys? Zuby thought he would overshadow Joe and do his own vault segment.
Whatever. I can retire.
Yeah, why don't we check this out? We'll be right back, guys.
Special edition of the vault from Area 51. I'm here with my new friend Cupcake. He's showing us around. He's done a fantastic job in this field. It's gorgeous out here. And he's brought some of his toys out. So let us in the know what you got here.
Well, first off, we have the little known Tippmann Ordnance TM203 breech loading grenade launcher. Then we also have a Ben Sheridan PGP
rock. The
brass
in the house.
Pump pistol still works
flawlessly.
The Ben Sheridan equalizer,
which,
yeah, that little
equalizer. Yeah.
This gun was stopped production because it is unsafe. This gun chronos in at 480 with CO2.
It's a little hot.
Yeah. Crossfire at one point made barrels. This is the Crossfire Ramrod. This is the barrel plug. You could actually shoot through a barrel break, no problem, because it would not stay in your barrel. I have a AGD mini mag, Zuby's favorite, with the die mag barrel.
Level 10.
Equipped. A Tippmann 68 carbine that I have custom Stormtroop painted with a quick disconnect ASA. And my favorite, the Tippmann ProLite, that at one point, the original Tippmann ProLite, that was in a jar sitting on a counter, and I got bored one night and put it all back together without instructions.
Yes. All right, and I happen to notice a little something when we walked in the shop
this
here.
This has been on a custom corner, but whoa,
it's a man's paintball marker.
The Area 51 Triclops.
That is gorgeous. Absolutely gorgeous.
Would you like to hold it?
Imagine this coming at you.
Zuby!
Yeah!
Cover fire!
Nice very job, nice. Zuby.
Thank you.
Ah, you said like that was nice and light, that A5?
Oh, yeah, no problem.
Very nice. And thank you to the person who just chipped in $5. You know who you are. Dustin, we have a couple more questions to get to tonight.
I do. I have a question courtesy of Timothy Panda via Clint Rattel. And he asks, what are the best ways to safely promote our sport in a community that has three fields, and how do we unite as a brotherhood?
Good luck.
Yeah, you are talking about a very highly competitive, you know, competitive sport and business. I mean, Joe and I are from Southwestern Ontario, and there's about a million fields within throwing distance of ours, and it's hard. I mean, there's only so many weekends of the year. There's only so many times you can schedule your game when no one else is doing theirs. First and foremost, I would try and get those three field owners together in one room and agree upon one thing to start with, and that is when their major events are. Once those are put on the calendar and agreed upon, that at least opens the lines of communication, and then you can sort of move on. But also, you know, if field owners get together and standardize their pricing and bring it to a level that's acceptable that everyone can enjoy, then, you know, it forces your local fields to take their service up, takes their field design up. It's a win-win, I think.
Mm-hmm.
You guys can also answer.
That's good. I think as a field owner, it's important to have space between major dates. If you're three or four feet a week,
away from specialized events. It gives a player an opportunity to visit different locations without breaking their bank.
And if you're a field owner, why compete with the other field owner? Talk about it. You know, spread it out. You know, paintball players only have so much money, as you guys all well know. So if you and that'll make an opportunity for you guys to go to all the events too if they're spread out. So no need to have to choose.
But there's always a field owner that will have an event, a nearly free event on the same day as you do.
Just there's always field owners that try to be just guys, for
just
sure.
Guys.
Dustin, we have more questions. And
yes,
while we're
I do.
Talking about that, guys, if you have any questions or concerns, send them into show@behindthebunker.com. That is our umbrella email, and we'll try and get your questions on the air as well. And if anybody in the chat forum has a quick question to throw out at us, definitely take care of that. Put it up there, and we'll see if we can get to them tonight.
The next question I have here is from Mike Langlo, and he asks, what is the shelf life of a typical case of paintball?
4 to 6 months. I would say 4 to 6 months.
Depending on storage.
Depending on how it's stored. If you play in June and you're going to play again, you know, in a month and a half, just keep the paint. Read the box instructions and just keep the paint dry in a relatively low humidity area and just rotate it periodically so the balls stay round. Yep. You can cup them in your hand if you want, or just rotate the box.
Or let someone else.
Where's
do
my
it
bell
for
here?
Quiet.
Come on.
As cheesy as it sounds, I equate paintballs to pastry. I know this sounds stupid, but I always say the fresher the better.
And they're both delicious.
And they're very delicious.
Jack, just ask Jack.
Jack, if he's watching at home, knows that all too well. Now, I'm going to play
a
quick video here. First of all, I want to show you a poster that we showed a couple weeks ago, 3 weeks ago actually. This was a poster put out. A gentleman was building a bridge in the UK and was putting a call out to see if anyone else knew of any bridge bigger than that. He has it 350 feet long, over 40 feet high, at the Yorkshire Paintball Centre in UK. Now, after I did this, somebody sent in this video of something that was being built, and I believe, I apologize, I don't have my notes here, but I believe it was in Hawaii. Matt, can you play it? Yeah. And then Matt, there we go. So yes, we can talk over this. That was. As you can see, guys, they have this this bridge suspended in this forest. It looks fantastic.
They're making an Ewok village.
That's right. Yeah. I would not want to build that.
Wouldn't it get slippery with the snow?
Well, this is Hawaii.
What about lava? Oh, they can walk. If a volcano erupts around, they can still play.
Safety
elevate.
First.
Oh,
safety first.
That's why. See, I guess they elevated in case the lava flow. They can never have to stop the big
game.
Or overflowing poi dishes.
Now, I do understand, and I think this looks really cool, but I do hope that they're putting rails on, because with slick paint on there, I'm sure someone's going to.
No, they don't. They don't need railings or ear protection in Hawaii.
Now, the only thing I do know about this, according to the description in the YouTube, was that they used over 4 miles of wood. Of lumber, so I don't know what that would equate to, but
kilometers,
I don't have that exactly.
1.16 times.
But well, I guess there they go. They put rails on there, and they've got
shutters. Like being in Key West.
Very nice. Maybe that's the beginning of a resort in Hawaii. I'm not sure.
Not very hurricane proof though.
Plus, but it's lava proof.
You know,
that's
what would
matters.
Be good if they were, women were wearing grass skirts running around. You could stand underneath.
It's almost like we're playing a virtual reality game, first-person shooter game here. I'm almost getting dizzy. Anyways, I just wanted to show that to you guys. So yeah, it's pretty neat. I'm glad that you guys sent that in. So Dustin, do we have any other questions before we go?
Sure. Why not?
Asylum Assassin Steiner is saying 6.4 kilometers.
Okay, good.
Mm-hmm. Are you ready for me now?
Yeah, Gwyn talk.
Yes. Sure. And next question I have is, doesn't say from who, but he writes, I have a Tippmann 98 and recently purchased a Rampage board for it. But my question is, what is the best hopper for this setup? The website says the board will shoot up to 30 balls a second, but people say it won't go that fast. How fast do you think it'll shoot, and what hopper do you think will best match that marker?
Was that a 98?
A 98, so a 98 with a...
You're going to need a cyclone feed. I don't know if a cyclone feed will keep up to it. You may need to find an aftermarket feed neck. I know Lapco used to make a 45 degree that would fuse like a motorized loader, would push the balls right into the breech, because the standard feed neck of a 98 is far too crude to accommodate 30 balls per second.
The old Q loader, maybe? But you know what? Okay, it's great that your gun shoots 30 balls a second. Good job.
30 balls a, but misses a second.
Do you know what? Like, do you seriously need 30 balls a second? I mean, if 15 to me is even a lot of pain. If you're shooting a guy at 15 balls a second and he runs past you, you're a bad shot.
That's 1,800 rounds a minute.
15 balls a second. That's ridiculous. I mean, it's great. You know, you get the guys that have, you know, the Rotor, the Z2, any of the fast hoppers, and they say, you know, can go over, you know, so many feet, you know, so many feet per second. What's wrong? Okay. So, let me dump this. That should help. Hmm. Sorry, guys, we're having some technical difficulty. So, I don't know. Good for you for having 30 balls a second, but I don't know when you'd ever need that. So, anyways, we're going to wrap it up because we're having some technical issues. I want to send out a humble apology to the cat check, first of all.
Sorry, Tom.
For some reason, your video is not playing. Matt's tried it a couple times, and it's not rendering properly. So we will get that up on YouTube for you guys to see. And check out Cat Check, guys. He's always got great stuff. And his new website looks fantastic if you haven't checked it out. Yeah, Zuby, anything that you want to promote or talk about before we end the show?
Paintball around the world. If you have anything you'd like to send it to show@behindthebunker.com. Stop by our Facebook page and grab the Behind the Bunker logo and make sure it's on the poster.
Very nice.
Joe?
If you have anything that you've customized, modified, painted, or done to in any way, mask, goggles, or marker, please send it in to Custom Corner for show@behindthebunker or vice versa.
Very good.
And whatever's bothering you about the sport of paintball, the industry, anything in particular, show@behindthebunker.com. We'll discuss that on What's Up With That. And don't forget, folks, to click the bottom. For those of you who helped us out, thank you so much. Chip in, support packages, every little bit counts. Thank you.
Ah, we just had another $10. Thank you very much. You know who you are, sir. Chris, on the couch, thank you for coming in tonight.
Thank you, Todd. Guys, just want to remind you that now we have definitively named my segment Play While You Stay. Looking for a bumper for that segment. If you have any ideas and want to throw something together, please email us at show@behindthebunker.com. And anyone who gets a successful bumper into me will have to figure out some sort of intern prize for that.
I don't have-